Hello everyone, today I am here with one session on asphyxia neonatorum. It is also called perinatal asphyxia. Perinatal means when any condition develops in the 7 days of childbirth. First 7 days of childbirth, the first week of childbirth is called perinatal. So when the asphyxia that develops during this period is called perinatal asphyxia. By definition, it is non-establishment of satisfactory pulmonary respiration at birth. That means at birth, if rhythmic respiration does not start, we call it asphyxia neonatorum. Essential characteristics to diagnose to detect perinatal asphyxia. How can we know perinatal asphyxia has occurred? So there are some peculiar findings to diagnose or to detect this condition. Profound acidemia when pH is below 7 on umbilical arterial blood sample. When the umbilical cord artery or the umbilical artery blood is taken, the sample is taken, you will find the pH below 7. So it is highly acidic. Apgar score is 0 to 3 continuously for more than 5 minutes. What is Apgar score? That I am just coming to it. Right now you just remember Apgar score, when it is 0 to 3 continuously, constantly for more than 5 minutes, indicates perinatal asphyxia. Neurological manifestations like hypotonia. Hypotonia is very low muscle tone or reduced muscle tone. Coma and seizure. Seizure means convulsion. So when these neurological manifestations develop after birth, these also indicates perinatal asphyxia. And multi-organ system dysfunction. So that is when multi-organ failure or dysfunction, you can say the asphyxia has started. Now when does it begin? In 90% cases, the asphyxia is antepartum or intrapartum in origin. Antepartum means starts during pregnancy only, or it may be intrapartum means starts during delivery. The cause of the origin is placental insufficiency, either due to placenta previa or accidental hemorrhage or due to any other reason. Whenever there is placental insufficiency, it will lead to asphyxia after the birth. So in about 90% cases, you will find that it starts during pregnancy or during labor. In the remaining 10% cases, you will find it is postnatal, that means develops or starts after the birth. Now Apgar score. In the previous slide, we talked about the Apgar score, one of the important characteristics to diagnose of this asphyxia neonatorum. What is this Apgar score? It is a scoring procedure to know the severity of the asphyxia. How severe the asphyxia is, that can be known by getting this Apgar score. It was established by Dr. Virginia Apgar in the year 1953. Five components, or the components are also called parameters, they are to be obtained in the Apgar score. Now let's see what is Apgar score. Here is the picture of Apgar score. The five components of the Apgar score are respiratory efforts, heart rate, muscle tone, reflex irritability, and the color of the skin. For each component, three scores are given, 0, 1, and 2, depending on the response or the reaction you get in the newborn. If respiratory effort is absent, no respiration, the score is 0. If respiration is slow but irregular, the score is 1. And if the respiration is well, it is good, the sign of the good respiration is the newborn will start crying. When the newborn cries, it is a good sign. Otherwise, crying is not good, right? But when the newborn cries, we can say that respiration has rhythmically established. The doctor is worried if the child, the newborn, does not cry after the birth. So respiratory efforts are good, if the newborn cries, and that will be given the score 2. Next component is heart rate. If no heart rate, score is 0. If the heart rate is below 100 beats per minute, the score is 1. And if it is above 100 per minute, the score is 2. Third component is muscle tone. It is flaccid, no response, muscle tone remains as it is, the score is 0. Flexion of extremities, that means the score is 1. Flexion of extremities, the score is 1. And active body movements, the newborn is moving the extremities and everything very well. Movements are very well, that means the score is 2. The fourth component is reflex excitability or reflex irritability, you can say. These can be tested by passing catheter into the nose of the newborn. Catheter is passed into the nose of the newborn. Now, catheter is the foreign body. When catheter is introduced into the nose, that means into the air passage, what the newborn will respond? Immediately will start sneezing or coughing, because the catheter is the foreign body. So when introduced into the air passage, it obstructs the air passage, and immediately not only the newborn, even we respond to the same. In the same way, we start sneezing or coughing whenever our air passage gets obstructed. So irritability response can be checked by this method, right? If no response, even though you pass catheter, the newborn does not respond, there is no sneezing, no coughing, that means the score is 0. Grimace means unlike facial expression. તમારું મોં મચકો ડઈ જાય, સપોઝ કંઈ પણ તમને ના ગમતું હોય તો તમે શું કરો? તરત જ તમારા ફેસના એક્સપ્રેશન ચેન્જ થઈ જાય. અને કેવા ચેન્જ થાય? તરત જ ખબર પડે કે આ વસ્તુ તમને ગમી નથી. દેટ ઇઝ કોલ ગ્રીમેઝ. સો ધ સેમ એક્સપ્રેશન યુ ફાઇન્ડ ઇન ધ ન્યૂબોર્ન્સ ફેસ, દેટ ઇઝ સ્કોર 1. એન્ડ ઇમિજિએટલી સ્ટાર્ટ્સ કફિંગ ઓર સ્નીઝિંગ, દેટ મીન્સ સ્કોર 2. Active response, immediate response, right? That is score 2. And the last component is color of the skin. If the color is blue, pale, this blueness indicates cyanosis. So if you find the color of the skin blue, it means that the score is 0. The newborn's body is totally cyanosed. Score 1 means body is pink but extremities are blue. Body is pink but extremities are blue. Extremities blue means it indicates peripheral cyanosis. That is score 1. And when the whole body is pink, it is score 2. So likewise, you have to get all these 5 components and you have to give marking score to each component. Then get total score. Add all the score of each component and get the total score. The maximum total score can be 10, because each component gets maximum 2 score, and there are such 5 components. So maximum Apgar score is 10, right? How can you know the severity of asphyxia? This depression, which is mentioned under this table, depression indicates asphyxia. So when the Apgar score is 8 to 10, that means no depression, no asphyxia. The child is very healthy, child is non-asphyxiated. One of the purpose of management of labor is to have the child who is non-asphyxiated. So when the Apgar score is 8 to 10, that means asphyxia is not there at all. When the Apgar score is 5 to 7, this means mild asphyxia. 5 to 7 indicates mild asphyxia. Apgar score 3 to 4. Indicates moderate asphyxia. It indicates moderate asphyxia. So as the asphyxia worsens, as the asphyxia goes high, becomes severe, Apgar score is getting low, right? So 8 to 10 Apgar score means no asphyxia. 5 to 7 Apgar score means mild asphyxia. 3 to 4 Apgar score means moderate asphyxia, and 0 to 2 Apgar score means severe asphyxia. So high Apgar score is in favor of healthy newborn, and the low Apgar score is in favor of the severe asphyxia. Now, when to get these Apgar score, when to obtain these Apgar score? Apgar score is evaluated for the first time at 1 minute after birth to check the severity of the asphyxia. So Apgar score for the first time evaluated at 1 minute of newborn's birth, at 1 minute of childbirth. And the purpose of getting Apgar score for the first time is to know the severity of the asphyxia. This we just discussed. What Apgar score you find, whether 8 to 10, 5 to 7, 3 to 4 or 0 to 2. Depending on this Apgar score, you can decide the severity of the asphyxia, whether it is mild, moderate or severe. And depending on this severity, you will start the treatment, because treatment also depends on the severity of the asphyxia. All the cases of the asphyxia are not given the same treatment. The line of treatment depends on severity of the asphyxia, right? So the Apgar score for the first time evaluated to know the severity of the asphyxia, and that is evaluated at 1 minute of the childbirth. Now, after you start the treatment, what should happen? Apgar score should go high, right? So the severe asphyxia should enter the moderate asphyxia, and the moderate one should go into the mild asphyxia, right? So Apgar score should be high. It should go high after you start the treatment, if your treatment is effective. So to check whether the treatment is effective or not, whether what treatment you have started is satisfactory or not, we have to re-evaluate the Apgar score at 5 minutes. So Apgar score is re-evaluated at 5 minutes after birth to know the efficacy of the treatment you have started. What treatment you have given, whether it is appropriate or not, that can be checked by re-evaluation of the Apgar score at 5 minutes. Suppose if you find that Apgar score is getting down, whatever it was earlier, it is still lower than that. That means your line of treatment is not good, it is not right, or whatever treatment you have started is not enough for that level of the asphyxia. You need to give more exhaustive treatment to the newborn, right? So Apgar score is very, very important to know the asphyxia and for the line of treatment, whether it is effective or not, right? Sometimes in your exam, this Apgar score may be asked as 5 mark short note. Asphyxia neonatorum is not generally asked in the exam, but what is more asked is this Apgar score. Now the management of the Apgar score, management of the asphyxia, there can be two types of the management, preventive and definitive. You can see definitive would be the treatment of the asphyxia, not management. In the preventive part, we can say antenatal detection of high-risk patients. The patients who are more likely to get placental insufficiency, that means APH, the patients who are likely to get APH or who have developed APH during their pregnancy, they are high-risk patients for the asphyxia, right? So such cases should be found out, should be detected as early as possible, so that we can minimize the complication after birth. We can minimize the asphyxia, right, by timely birth of the child. Antepartum and intrapartum fetal monitoring should be done to detect this condition at the earliest. Like what I said you, if the placental insufficiency is detected during pregnancy only, that can be known by the fetal monitoring, by regular USG, right? This can be detected at the earliest, so we can minimize the complications. Judicious use of anesthetic agents and sedatives during labor. These we are talking about the intrapartum asphyxia. During labor or during the cesarean section, anesthesia is given to the patient. Sedatives may be used during labor. So these drugs should be given only under medical supervision. There should not be haphazard use of these drugs, right? This is to prevent or to avoid asphyxia in the newborn. Avoidance of the difficult and traumatic delivery. So whenever you find that delivery is going to happen difficult or there may be trauma very likely to occur during labor, then such incidents should be avoided. It is better to plan cesarean section in such suspected cases. So these are all preventive measures for the asphyxia. The definitive treatment depends on the Apgar score. As I told you, Apgar score means depends on severity of the asphyxia. How severe the asphyxia is, that will decide the line of the treatment. We are not going into detail of the treatment because whenever you get such patient, we are more concerned with the homeopathic mode of treatment. And for the asphyxia neonatorum, we have very good drugs in homeopathy like carbovage, antimtart, opium, sulfur. These drugs may be used for the asphyxia neonatorum. Okay, thank you.